Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. I hope y'all are having a fabulous day wherever you are. Today we are doing a speed cast and then also a mansion tour. Ooh, fancy. So I'm going to be starting a new legacy challenge, and this is called the Pimlico Legacy Challenge. It was created by a fellow small Sims YouTuber by the name of Lizzie Lily. I will link her channel as well as the rules and everything for the challenge in the description below for you guys. So this challenge starts with a founder, and right now this is the speed cast of my founder. Her name is Madeline Hurst. And each generation has their own specific room of the mansion, or I guess like area of the mansion that is their job to furnish and manage and do all of that kind of stuff. So the rooms in the mansion are, you have to have a kitchen, a dining room, a gallery room, an outdoor pool, a nursery, a twin children's room, a teen rec room, a granny suite or a granny annex, 4 double bedrooms, 3 bathrooms, a parlor, a reception room slash lounge, and a basement lair. And so each generation is responsible for one of those sections. So the first generation, as you can see by her aspiration, she is the kitchen or the chef aspiration. So she wants to be a master chef. She's a foodie. She's a little bit lazy, and she's also creative. I was looking up like random name and character stuff online just to get like a random name, because I'm really bad at coming up with names. And so I ended up with Madeline Hurst, and it was really funny because I actually generated like I guess it was a small storyline or backstory for the Madeline Hurst character that I had generated. And it was funny because it actually determined that she was a sous chef, which I thought was kind of hilarious because that's her aspiration, and that's what she is going to do in this legacy challenge. So it was interesting that the random name generator also gave her the chef aspiration, or she was a sous chef in the little backstory. So Madeline here, or Maddie is her nickname. She likes to go by Maddie. She's a really casual Sim. She doesn't really put on a lot of makeup. She has a very simple wardrobe. Her favorite color is blue. I don't really know why I chose blue, but it's blue. I think in her backstory it actually said that she wanted to be painted blue, which I don't know if that's a literal thing, like she wants to be painted in the color blue, or if it was more of like a I'm sad. I'm not really sure, but I interpreted it as her favorite color is blue. So most of her outfits have at least one blue something in it, whether it be blue jeans or a blue shirt, or I think in one of her outfits, I think her formal wear, she has blue heels on. But she's super casual. She doesn't wear jewelry. She doesn't wear a lot of makeup. I mean, she's a chef. She doesn't have time for that kind of stuff. It's a lot of work being a chef. My father was a chef in real life, so I definitely know that being a chef comes with a lot of late nights and early mornings. And so she just doesn't really have a lot of time to put on a bunch of makeup or put on a bunch of jewelry or anything like that. I also gave her a haircut with bangs because I don't normally do bangs on my Sims. I don't know why. I just don't generally gravitate towards bangs, I guess. But I thought it would be fun to just try something different. And so she has a hairstyle. Generally, this is the hairstyle that she wears most of the time, and it is by Sim Mandy, is the creator of that CC hair and CC. Most of the hairs I use are CC. There are quite a few hairs in the game that I actually do enjoy, but for the most part I use CC hairs. But the one that she mainly wears is by Sim Mandy. This one isn't. I think that this one is by... I'm not sure actually, I'd have to check. I'm sure it'll come up again. Maybe you guys will be sleuthy enough to catch it, even though I was not. And she mostly wears her hair down. She's also, even though there's only 3 traits in The Sims, she's also very active. She likes to work out, as you can tell by her marvelous six-pack. She really enjoys working out. She's a very active person. It helps her with her job, because if she's really in shape, then she'll perform better at her job, because being a chef is really hard, like I said. But yeah, she's just a really simple gal, you know. In the backstory, it actually had some relationships. And I think I will show it later when we do the mansion tour. I'll show you the webpage, I guess, that the backstory came from. But it had some friends set up for her and an ex-boyfriend set up for her, which I thought was really interesting because she is going to start out as single because she has to get a husband to create an heir for the next generation, so on and so forth. But I think I'm actually going to create those Sims that it has in the backstory. It doesn't have a lot of information about them, but it does have their names, and I think it has the occupation for one or two of them. So I'll probably create them and put them into the world because I think it could be fun. But yeah, so the generations are pretty loose. You can like make the Sim however you want to make the Sim, but they have to have a certain aspiration. They have to be in a certain career or group of careers, and there are certain skills that they have to master. So they can only work on the room that is their assigned generation mostly. I think there's an $1,800 limit on any room that is not part of their generation until you reach a certain generation, which I think is generation 6 or generation 7, where you can then, I think generation 6. Then there's no longer a spending limit for any room on the house, in the house. And then for each generation, they also will use the reward items that they get from their careers. So like the countertops and the fridge and all that kind of stuff that you get from moving through the culinary career and whatnot, will be the furnishings of the kitchen. And then you can also always add other things into the kitchen, like decorations and clutter and other types of things. But yeah, so now I'm just working on the last of her clothes. I did give her multiple outfits for each type of weather and whatnot because we're gonna be seeing a lot of her, so I feel like it's only important that she has lots of options to wear. But yeah, we're just about done here, and so now we are going to move into the mansion tour. Okay, so now that we have Maddie all done, we are gonna move her into her new mansion, but obviously it costs a little bit too much money. So we are going to turn on free real estate. Beautiful. And then we're gonna move her in. Beautiful. Confirm. We'll keep it furnished. Whatever. All right, let's go. Here we are, and last exception, hush. Isn't she gorgeous? I mean, wow, look at that, there's a heat wave going on. I mean, look at this mansion. All right, we'll do a nice little bird's eye view. So here it is. This is a 64 by 64 lot. She's beaut. It is filled with dead, overgrown grass and trees and whatnot. And the walls are, I don't know what's going on here. We're just gonna ignore it. So here's our front door. I chose it's kind of a nice front door because it's from Strangerville, but it has a funky looking color, so it's like dirty and gross, and over time we'll hopefully upgrade it into a nicer door than what it currently is. But let's go inside. We'll slowly make our way in. Oh my gosh, there's no lights. I wonder why. This is the front entrance. Isn't it beautiful? It's big and grand, and there's a tree in the wall. That's fine. It has two beautiful grand staircases that lead to the second floor, but we'll get there when we get there. So if we go this way, this is going to be the kitchen, and then if we go through here, this is going to be the dining room eventually, and then it leads out to the back patio. Through here, there's a lot of archways. It's really nice. This is going to be like the parlor type of room, I think, or like the reception room. I don't really know. This is back towards the hallway towards the front. If we go through the middle here, we get another beautiful hallway. This is the parlor again. And then over here, I'm getting lost. This is going to be like the reception lounge or whatever. They might be interchangeable. I might change them if I feel so inclined. Then here is a bathroom. That's going to be right off of the little parlor thing. And then if we go through this door here, this is going to be the teen rec room. So I set up this mansion to already have all of the rooms set aside for each of the different generations and all of the different things that they need for the Pimlico Challenge. I mean, I might make changes later on if I don't like the layout now, but for now, I'm pretty pleased. And then this also is just leads to that same bathroom that is attached to the parlor room. Here's the front again. But yeah, it's got a beautiful big ceiling. So if we go over here, this is the other side of the house. This is going to be the nursery. Now, maybe it's just my Americanness, but I don't know if they meant nursery like a plant nursery or like a child nursery. So if it's child nursery, that's what this is. If it's a plant nursery, I'll put more windows in or something and I'll make it like a modern extension. If we go this way and we go through this door, this is going to be the art gallery room, which is really nice. Here is the secret door that's going to lead to the basement lair. And then now we are going to go up some of these stairs. We go over here. I'm going too fast. I can't control my camera. This is a bathroom, a beautiful hall bathroom. This is a beautiful bedroom. Go back out this way. This is another beautiful bedroom, a beautiful bedroom. This one has an ensuite. Gorgeous. It's a very small ensuite, but it's a nice bedroom. Has lots of windows. I think this might be my founder's bedroom. I haven't decided. I'm between that bedroom and this bedroom for my founder. This one has a lot fewer windows, but this one has a much larger bathroom with a lot of windows in it. So I haven't exactly decided yet. I'll probably put her in the back bedroom for now. And then over here is another bedroom. This is gonna be like the twin kids bedroom. I think that's all the rooms. Oh, I haven't done... Silly me. We have not done the granny annex. Oh my god, how could I possibly forget? So if you go around this way, there's this beautiful little tiny house here. It's like a granny suite or a mother-in-law annex house or whatever. I actually was really happy with this. I thought it was really cute. I considered just doing a suite attached to the house, but I decided not to. So this is the granny suite. This is gonna be like this living area. This is a door. She has a little patio that leads like right up to the... There was a pathway there. It's gone now. That's fine. My pathway there is gone too. Anyway, I'll fix that later. This is gonna lead to the porch for the main house. This is a bathroom. Excuse me, bathroom. This is gonna be probably the kitchen, and then this is probably gonna be the dining room, and then we can go up the stairs, and then this is a bathroom, just another bathroom. This will be like her personal bathroom, whereas one downstairs would be like a public bathroom, I guess. And then this is like her, I guess, room. I figured I'd make it like an open concept loft style upper area because it's specifically for grandparents or mother-in-laws or whatever it may be. And then she has a beautiful porch that's overlooking a beautiful stone that I'm going to collect. Love it. But yeah, that is everything. So I'll take us out of tab and then we can get a nice little bird's eye view of all of the floors. So here's the first floor. This is the entryway, kitchen, dining, parlor, hallway, reception, gallery, nursery, bathroom, teen rec room, and then granny annex. And then upstairs you have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 bedrooms and 3 bathrooms, 2 of them being an ensuite bathroom. Yeah, that's the entire thing. Over time, we'll get rid of all of the dirty, gross, run-down plants. There's someone outside my window doing something and making noise, and I don't know if you can hear it, but I can. I had more walkway here too. Okay, it destroyed my walkway, but it's fine. I'll fix it later. But over time, we will fix up all of the cracks and all of that kind of stuff, and we will, you know, make the roof a prettier, like a darker color rather than this like dingy brown. And I'm thinking of making it more of like a modern style mansion that just needs to be upgraded a little bit. But yeah, let me know if you guys are excited to experience this with Madeline. Let me put on her money down to 1800. Oh, there should be a space there. Beautiful. So she is all ready to start her journey as the founder of her little Pimlico challenge, the Hearst Legacy. Let me know what you guys think. I can also link some of her CC, maybe not in this video, but I can pin most of it to my Tumblr page. It's just Serensimity, like everything else in my existence. But yeah, let me guys know what you think of her and what you guys think of her lovely mansion. And I will see y'all in the true part one of this, where we get started her as a chef. When I was trying to generate a name for her, it generated a story, and it was funny because the story that it generated was that she is a sous chef. Yeah, I think it'll be fun to kind of follow this. I'm thinking I'm also going to make these people that it recommends right here. So her most recent romance was with an artist named Jackson Philip Freeman, and they broke up because he was threatened by her intelligence. And her best friend is named Ray Oliver, and she also hangs around with two people named Allison Griffin and Blake Barnes. So I think that I will actually make those characters just to have in the world, and I'll establish a relationship with them, just to add a little bit more depth. And I think it would be fun to kind of follow. I mean, this doesn't really have a lot of information, but it gives us a nice starting point just for funsies. So yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed. I will see y'all in the next one. Bye!